Arkadaşlar merhabalar. Bugün 12 Haziran 2024 Çarşamba. Ben Bahattin Çağdaş. Biraz önce işte bir toplantıda bulunmuştuk. Emre Aracı, uzun süredir İngiltere'de yaşayan Doktor Emre Aracı, gezgin, müzisyen, sanatçı, bir kitap yayınlamış. Londra'da Türk İzleri diye. İlginç bir kitap. Şimdi toplantıyı bunun peşine bırakacağım ben size. bir toplantı esnasında bir şey sordum. pardon. Şeydi, Turkset Pub, Türk kelleleri, publar var ya, publarının isimleri. Ben onunla ilgili bir video yapmıştım, hatırlarsınız. Onu sordum, onun hikayesini biliyor musunuz diye. Yani sahiden savaştan getirilen Türk kelleleri mi diye. Bilgim yok dedi. Bir de şeyi sordum. Milli Türk Bankası, tam da Ziraat Bankası var. Onu göstermişti, slide gösterisinde. Onun yanında. Yani bizim gibi görünen ama bize ait olmayan banka. Onunla ilgili bilgisi var mı dedim. O da yok dedi. Son olarak da şeyi sordum. 1913'te bazı kitaplar biliyorsunuz Mustafa Kemal'in şeye geldiğini, İngiltere'ye geldiğini söylüyor. Onunla ilgili bilgi var mı dedim. O da yok dedi. Şimdi bunu peşine bırakıyorum. Bir de ayrıca seminerden sonra da ayaküstü sormaya çalıştım. Aynı şeyleri tekrarladım. ve seminerden de görüntüler var. Peki, sizi baş başa bırakıyorum. Bir saniye. Emre Bey, I came a little bit late. Have you mentioned about Turks Head Pubs, first one, and second one next to you told Ziraat Bankası. Yeah. Next to there is a National Turks Banks. Do you know any idea about
that? Yeah, but there was the Ottoman Bank in the city in the 19th century, but the one you mentioned, I don't know. But the Turk's Head pubs, yes, I have just referred to one of the sides. Also an area of, there's so many of them around in the country. Yeah.
Turk's Heads pubs?
Yes. Oh, yes. Mm. I mean, I went to Northumberland, there was one there. Exeter, there's one there. So you see them around quite a lot. It's an area of study in its own right, I suppose. Yeah. So, yes, thank you.
Yeah, I will ask a bit personal question to you.
Yes.
I think you really love...
Emre Bey, short question. Some books says 1913, Mustafa Kemal came to UK. Do you have any detail or...
I don't know that at all. I know that King Edward VIII went to Istanbul, famous and then wonderful... photographs of that trip, and it was widely covered, but I had no knowledge of other people coming over to this country at all.
Nearly Exeter's, he went.
I don't know at all. So thank you all very much, ladies and gentlemen. I'd be very happy to sign you. Thank you for coming. And look out for all those connections. Look out for them. Thank you.
Turk's Head hikayesi acaba doğru mu? Yani Türklerin kellesi kesilip buraya kondu falan gibi hikayeden bahsediliyor.
Hiç bilmiyorum. Yani,
peki ilk izlerimiz ne zaman başladı? Kabaca tarih burada İngiltere'de.
Yani ona bir tarih koymayız ama İngiltere ile ticaret anlamında belirli ilişkilerin başladığını biliyoruz. 16. yüzyıl. William Hubble'ın atması ve orada işte bu Arlen de Bar Company'nin ticaretleri ve bahsettiğim 1599'da Kraliçe Elizabeth'in yollaması hediye olarak de Bar Company'nin Sultan III. Mehmet'in.
İyi akşamlar.
Peki, teşekkür ederim. Sağ olun. Sağ olun. Sağ olun. T ile mi yazıyorum?
Ben çantaları getirsin.
Arkadaşlar bugün Orika Sıran 2024.
Aynen değil mi?
Ben bir sonraki adımı düşünürüzü
ile Londra'da Türk İzleri kitabı.
Ama
Napoleon invaded Egypt. So the Ottoman Sultan Selim III bestowed upon him the Order of the Crescent, which he proudly wore on, as you can see, on his uniforms, and it was actually stitched as well onto his uniforms, and you can see it on display at Greenwich Royal Maritime Museum. And on his also a gift was a gift from Selim III, and in fact you can see it. You won't be able to see it, but I can show you the photograph close up of his statue on Trafalgar Square, that big, big column. But there is this, the Ottoman medal there and the Çelenk. Sadly, nature and art and the air of heaven are all equally mixed in vast quantities with a generous hand. Wonderful. So you can really feel the mist of Istanbul lifting one morning in the words of Virginia Woolf. It is so fitting. I took you on a walk with Mrs. Dalloway, but this diagram, this lovely diagram, because you could have it yet, is Turkish bath, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, Sherlock Holmes. My goodness, so this was quite an amateur cricket club that they got together. But there is a letter, and I have this original letter too in my research. I found this original letter, and it is from the secretary of Sir James Barry, from the Sir James Barry. This is, dear Miss Carroll, in answer to your letter, I'm writing to say that owing to a prohibitive number of appeals, Sir James Barry has, but I remember the day when I went to the British Library and made a copy, a bit like Lady Mary Montagu's letters, of all the music on the, with a pencil, and subsequently, of course, I got the image as well, and we published it and recorded it with a group of musicians. Actually, that CD was recorded in London, and including the Sultan, of course. Abdulaziz appeared on the cover when he was given the British Order Knight of the Garden. The ceremony took place on board the Royal Yacht, Stormy Day, as you can see. And then final musical sample, and then I'll bring my presentation to a close, and I'll ask for a few questions, if you may have any. And this is La Gondole Barcarolle, that was composed by Sultan Abdulaziz. If we can hear that, please, just a minute of that. Because when he was in London, Prince of Wales gave a dinner. And at the dinner, as a surprise to the Sultan, they played his own La Gondole Barcarolle, which we're hearing at this very moment in the background. But there is also the, as you can see, newspaper advertisement bought by His Imperial Majesty the Sultan that I found in the archive. It's music. Because time is limited, but you can listen to all of them. It took place at Crystal Palace to an audience of 30,000, and the British chorus of 1,600 singers. I'd be happy to answer any questions. If not, I'd be happy to sign books. Thank you, whatever you wish me to do.
Thank you very much.